We're here doing our second Nurmagon pug of the day. Our first one was on Warrior. It was our first raid with the Epic Axe. It was sweet. I am here now on my Rogue, Simonize her. We're about to do a bunch of damage. We got a good looking group, two Shamans. We got Hunter. We got two Warriors. We got Battle Shout. We got Druid. We got Homunculus from Priest. Actually, I'm assuming this guy's running Homunculus. He actually might not be because I think he's... Oh, he is. Let's go. Nice. We just main spec over off spec rolls. Gonna see if we can get some loot. Open for the dagger from second boss, the belt from first boss, trinket off of last boss. There's a few things left that we need on this character. If you're watching on Twitch, or sorry, on YouTube, you should know that these runs are streamed live at twitch.tv/SimonizeShow. We are typically live Monday through Friday. About 1 p.m. EST to about 7 p.m. EST. But with phase two coming out, we will probably be streaming through the weekend, or sorry, phase three. When phase three comes out, we'll probably stream through the weekend, Saturday, Sunday, because, you know, that's hype, that's exciting, that's new stuff. Right. We are running 26 points assassination, 0 points combat, 5 points subtlety. This is just your standard, mutilate, daggers, PvE build. For this phase. So we're gonna look, pay attention when we get a radiation cloud spawning. Cause the trash wave that spawns with the second radiation cloud is the last trash wave. I think this is the first one. First radiation cloud. CTM redeemed change hat. Okay. There it is. Is that Pokemon music in the background? I think so. All right, we're just chilling. This is, I believe, second to last wave. So when the next wave comes out, I wanna blast all my energy, get a big slice and dice going, then let my energy fill up again. Not the greatest. They're dead. We enter stealth. We go in here. Grubbus is up. Slightly threat issues. Evasion is active though. Vanish. Nope. Didn't pay attention to that ability coming out. Evasion, Envenom failed. Waiting. Envenom again. What is... This is not going the way it probably should. I would say. Why am I bleeding out? Nature protection potion. I'm dead. Interesting. Someone has left the raid group already. Could this be a world record? Well, personal best for number of bosses defeated before our Nurmagon group collapses? This week we set our, for the longest time, my personal best for fewest number of bosses killed before the group collapses was 5. right? Like, I had some 5 out of 6 runs, and that was the worst it got. This week, I had 2 runs that went, 2 back-to-back runs that went 3 out of 6. Oh! We want that. I want that. 25. Damn. Femboy Kisser wants it also. Yeah, okay, fair. He needs it too. Insta equip. unfortunate. Discord not necessary. That's, I agree generally. But when you have multiple deaths on Grubbis, then you have to reevaluate how strong your players are. Man, I even hopped on a nature protection potion and I still managed to die. Did a vanish for a threat drop. Did evasion. I think we did pretty much all we could. Ooh, I was not expecting this raid to be another struggle bus of a raid, but it's off to a bad it's off to a start that makes me think we might be struggling. Let's just keep our head up, see what we can do. 100% play for the mechanics. Gonna make a Cata pre-patch Bissless and tutorial vid. Fuck Cataclysm. Full-time resident of Struggle City. I feel like struggle raids are better content than, like, getting the boys, you know, getting the squad together and just, you know, clearing it easily, you know? That guy's going the wrong way. What is even over there? I've actually never gone that way. Now I'm remembering from old Nomergon. It puts you out somewhere into this next room if you follow that path all around. You, like, get out over in there, I think. All right, we brought... Yeah, here we go. Of course there's just a random mob following us because someone went the wrong way. Why? What are we doing? I'm gonna inquire. See what they say. Beginning to wonder if this is a tank issue. If our tank doesn't know where they're going, that's scuffed. And maybe that was scuffed on, that was why Grubbus was scuffed. I can always swap to tank runes and just tank. See if, I don't think that's necessary at this point. But it is a possibility. You were on Grubbus instantly? Yeah, of course I was. Bro, are we pulling more mobs over here? What the hell, dude? What? I tried to inquire, what are we doing? I am now offering my tank services. We attempted to communicate on, like, why are we going this way, and we shared the information that, hey, you can just go left to the next boss. Yet the group just continued pulling these trogs that we don't actually have to have any reason to kill. They didn't provide a reason why we were doing that. They also didn't change their role of, like, where they were going, even after me attempting to communicate with them. So now, at this point, we offer our services as tank. How does the raid leader not notice that someone left? I don't know. Who cares? Those GigaChad parse runs? Yeah. This is why we pug on the Simon Eyes show. This is funny. And it does also lead sometimes to epic gamer moments where, like, I actually have to play out of my mind to turn a wipe into a kill. You know? Carry, like, every single mechanic at once. I now understand why you made the video about Nomer being too hard for... I don't think I ever said majority. I think I said, like, large enough... Say what I tried to say, or at least meant to say. I did say at least in some parts of it. Difficult, too hard for a large enough segment of the player base that gatekeeping invites to the raid becomes necessary if you want to have a smooth clear of the raid. Right? Okay, I think we're pulling the boss. Yep, boss is in. I didn't repop my consumables ever since Grubbus came out. Let's do that right now. Let's go with a nature potion right now also. Here's the important part. Please kill it. Yes, we got that one. Where's the final? Pick it. Bring it in. Nope, we're not bringing it in. Ooh, I did a stun on that. The Femboy Kisser actually got the interrupt. Okay, good. The mechanic was handled. You know what's going to be funny? After this, we're going to check the damage meter to see how much damage some of the raid members did to adds. We're going to make some guesses right now about who's tunneling the boss. Anyone have any guesses? Based on how the damage meter looks right now, who is tunneling the boss? Yep, second set of adds. What the? Is the boss on me? What's happening? I'm taking a lot of damage. Am I in, like, multiple poison slimes? It's like he didn't get moved out. It's fine. I think this turtle's gonna make... Oh, no, I have a stun. I was gonna say, I thought he was gonna make it to the water. He did not make it to the water. We killed almost all of them. Shadow step to this one. Interrupt his spell. See, these are, like, actual gamer moments where I'm doing... actual mechanics in the face of not very many other people doing mechanics. Okay, that wasn't actually that close. We've definitely had, you know, actually no one died. That puts it in the top half, I would say. Now, any guesses? Okay, this guy only dealt damage. I think he's healer, so that makes sense. Okay, this guy dealt damage to goo. This guy dealt damage to goo. Goo damage. Goo damage. Goo damage. 13,900 goo damage. Previous highest I observed was 6.7. Yeah, 6.7. Who would have guessed? I'm missing loot rolls. Oh well. Should have rolled for this, but who cares? It's like Giga side grade compared to what I've got. I was too focused on highlighting the fact that the Warlock didn't do a single, target swap to adds whatsoever. All right, now we have one of the best predictions of every Gnomergon raid. Prediction, start prediction. How many people will die on the next boss? Next boss is Crowd Pummeler, by the way. Damage. No epic weapon from the boss. Unlucky. We do need that still. Toxic Revenger. We're on Blood Harvest Blade. But that stupid elemental is the boss that should have dropped our epic dagger. I from Wyoming coming in with a tier 1. Thank you for 3 months of support. I appreciate that. Welcome back to the stream. Did someone rage quit after Grubbus? Yes. We can observe the death on Grubbus. Hang on. Grubbus. This player rage quit on Grubbus. Died and instantly left after he died. And we've just been nine-manning ever since. And that's the way it goes. That guy was saved, you know, either way. He doesn't avoid getting saved just because he, like, left the raid 3 seconds before Grubbus died, right after he died. If I wear tank runes just to be a back... That's the thing about rogue tank. It doesn't work to be a backup tank as a rogue. Because if you slam on just a flesh wound, well, one, you lose a fuckload of damage from not having deadly brute. Two, the threat generation from this is passive. You will be the tank because you will generate more threat than the tank if you even attack the same target. And this is also the rune that gives you the capability of taunting. So, trying to sit around and be like an off tank or like, oh, I'm gonna, do whatever. Hang on. I also missed something. I from Wyoming, not only, subbed at tier one for 3 months, requested a change hat that I actually missed. Here we go. Let's go for this one. There we go. It's a little small for me. You can see the brim distorts when I shove it onto my oversized head. All right, we're making progress. Pretty minimal communication in this group, but, like, a couple people died on Grubbus, but then we had literally zero deaths on Viscous Fallout. So that was, like, no problem. I think we still have it on, yeah, it's been on Master Looter this entire time. Kind of probably annoying for the raid leader. To have to, like, loot every green and every salvage. But if he, you know, that's not my problem. There's no shot I'd have Master Loot on during trash if I was raid leading. Old blood in venom. Like, I could just have this mob on me. It doesn't hurt that bad. Ooh, stun failed. In venom failed. Okay, in venom finally connected. Oh, what's he saying? Oh? Oh? How many you need? Oh, I think he was asking about the grime-encrusted salvages before. Banned the ass cams. What are you gonna do now? Yeah, Twitch has a new policy where you can't have a... Basically, you can't have a camera fixed to your boobs, butt, or groin for prolonged periods of time. Even if you're wearing green screen underwear and projecting Fortnite onto your own ass. Even then, that's not allowed. So what I think about this policy is... It's probably not going to change much. Which just doesn't have the balls to just be like, hey, this platform isn't about selling your OnlyFans and like advertising for your OnlyFans. This isn't a website that's supposed to be for sexual content. and they just like keep making these like slight rule changes where they're like, oh, this is going too far. We're gonna ban this specific thing that people are doing. And then people just like continue like sitting in a shallow pool in a bikini indoors. And that's the stream. And it's like, come on. Everyone knows what's going on here. Wait, you know what would be really funny? What if I've got enormous lats, okay? Think about this. I have enormous lats, and also my quads are pretty big. What if I put a skin-tight shirt on that was bright green, and I just had the whole stream with my back being essentially the entire camera view, and I broadcast World of Warcraft onto my back, and then I could just flex my lats all the time. Or at least a bit, or something, I don't know. Because the policy change specifically referenced groin, buttocks, and breasts. Okay? So not against the rules to broadcast onto your lats. All those muscles I've generated from doing pull-ups and from doing archery, dude, that's all in the back. All right, strategy review for Crowd Pummeler. This is very smart from the raid leader. The raid leader has correctly identified that they have players in this group that are pretty unfamiliar with what's going on. Let's put it that way. And because of that, they are doing a strategy review prior to this boss. I think I'm just gonna vanish. I definitely got too greedy at the start with the threat generation. I should have just like actually, when I saw the tank like go and do a crossbow and then just stand still until the boss got to them, I should have known like this shit isn't, there's not gonna be threat generation here. That guy's dead, nope. Yup, he is dead. Yup, he's gone. Over the edge. Oh god, I just did the gloves that generate more threat. I didn't see where my threat was currently. We're okay. We're okay. Wait, how is everyone alive? I thought one guy died. Ooh, there's another. Okay, that. Now someone's gone. It was our tank, and now it's on Femboy Kisser, who is probably gonna die. How is he alive again? He just got not. I'm not understanding what's I'm gonna have to check the tapes. See what exactly happened. You guys all saw him get like punted, right? And he was out of range of me. That's why his nameplate went gray. And Venom failed. I haven't used a Thistle Tea yet. I need to use a Thistle Tea. There we go. This is an over 2 minute kill of this boss. Blood Fury just came off cooldown. We did it. Good job. Gotta keep the vibes positive. Dielectric Safety Shield. Holy shit, we got an epic. Okay. Let's check the death count. We did have a stream prediction on how many people would die. There were 4 deaths. So what? There was like a Soulstone. Was it like Ankh? Soulstone and Battle Res, perhaps? Is that the last boss? It is for some people. Because they can't beat the next boss. Okay, I'm gonna put 10 minutes on the clock for the next prediction. How many people will die on Electrocutioner? This is... There are 3 more bosses, Mystery Guy. And if I was a betting man, I would guess we are not going to kill the next boss. That would be my guess. I think the best I would give us is like 40%. I mean, the thing is, you can do strategies on this boss where like a couple of players that are super aware of what's going on can like carry the boss, right? Carry the static arc. But also a couple of totally clueless players can move themselves to the completely wrong locations and screw it up for everyone else. You can have one player do the entirety of the arc if all the other players move to, like, the positions they're supposed to be. Right? Like, the strategy that has essentially one player handling it requires the other people to be, like, in one group that stays here and another group that stays there. Offering my services again, making sure the raid leader is aware that I have tanked many Gnomeregan runs. I think I just got I think I'm in the process of being promoted to tank. Yeah, I think I just got promoted to main tank. Bro, don't try to skip the pull. That's not gonna work. Someone's gonna ass pull it. This is not the group where you... Okay, is this... I've actually never successfully skipped that pull before. And this group, of all groups, is my first group to successfully skip it. Okay. I don't have any deadly poison on this character. That's probably fine. You mutilate. Do you have any gear swaps? No, of course not. Do I have anything good to put on my offhand? I would really like to have a deadly poison. I just don't have those because I wasn't planning on tanking on this character, and you know, you'd have no reason to use that on a damage dealer. Or sorry, yeah, right, on a damage dealer. Damn, Thor, you got him like 2 seconds before me. I had the right-click ban window open. Going on here. This guy looks AFK or something. I think the prediction is still up for how many people will die on Electrocutioner. I knew this guy would like that. Let me know who to buff. Is Rogue tanking now? And I say, Alpha me, baby. Kiss me. Because he said his character name is... Wait, I think I actually just implied that I'm a fem... Okay, I didn't Okay, I did that wrong. This whole play was like... His name has Kisser in it, and I didn't think it through the part where his name isn't just Kisser, it's Femboy Kisser. So, look, I didn't think that through. But we have Spirit. What's important is that we have Spirit of the Alpha now. Okay, that's what you need to focus on. Something wrong with that, Simon? No, but it's just not who I am. Oh yeah, I'm the tank now. I have to actually pull this shit. I was still on, like, halfway idle DPS brain. Here's the patrol. I definitely want to get that. There we go. Pulled almost all of the mobs. Those are still back there. Mechanized a sentry. Let me get you. Haunt first, then do some abilities. We just grabbed a whole bunch of mobs. So, unrealistic for me to hold threat on everyone, but we do want to focus on the elites and make sure we hold those. We didn't really. Yeah, whatever. No one's dead. We're fine. We need to clear out this room. Uh-oh. These are... They need to be pulled back quickly. That was a little bit close. Okay. Prediction is still available if you want to get your points in on how many people will die on Electrocutioner. Getting towards the end of the prediction being open. one little gnome back behind this tauren. Right there. Waiting for call from raid leader if we should grab it now or wait. I think they're confused. I think we should wait. Caster, where? The other side. Okay, yeah, they're definitely not clear on what's going on. Okay, they're moving in. Can you inspect the warrior and confirm he is using the spell power weapon? I looked like... Oh, he had a one-hander on before. Now he's on, yeah, Mograine's Might. This is where we're tanking. You're gonna kill him and get your Machinist Gloves? I believe, dude. We got Machinist Gloves on the Warrior today. How could we not get them on the Rogue also? Okay. We mostly have like a stack here and a stack there. That's good if they know to stay in those locations. I believe in us. Okay, here we go. We're in position. I got the nature lightning thing. And it's totally fine. My favorite part about this boss is tanking it. Because... I don't have to pay attention to shit. Just slightly reposition every time he does that. Oh! One down! It's okay. We can still do it. Zero betters in shambles. Although I would suspect there were not very many people who bet zero on this prediction. I have a massive threat lead right now. Let's get some DPS in. Let's hit that Nero-linked cowl. Nero-linked cowl's faded. We'll hit the gloves. Okay, seven people is enough. That's enough to alternate the thing. No, wait, we're at eight. Yeah, but I'm one of them. Right, so there's... Nine. 10 people, one left at Grubbus. One is dead, so we're down to eight. Then Rogue is tank, so we're down to seven people trading the static arcs. Reposition slightly. Go.
Hmm.
Okay. Wait, did this guy... Did he get battle res? How is he alive again? Did he run back? Okay, that's a second death. Now it's intense. Because we're on the edge of... Okay, that's three deaths. Okay, the prediction is officially a three or more death situation. We have a leprous machine smith. Fucking hell. Get... Was that a bad idea to run out and chase the machine smith? I think it was a bad idea. I saw them trying to bring the machine smith in. Yeah, I tried to get the machine smith when I saw it. Did I get a resist on that taunt? I don't know if I, Right. Mm-hmm. Choose outcome, yeah, three or more deaths. Warrior did 50 melee swings. That doesn't seem like AFK. It seems like 31 out of the 50 were glances. 9 parries. 9 misses, 6 parries, 3 dodges. We just get battle rezzed by this druid? I think so. Nice. Well, we did five heroic strikes. Wow, how are there 50 rend casts? That can't be right. Normal hits 48. Oh, maybe it's counting per damage tick. So maybe this is like 3 or 4 casts, each doing 11 ticks or 12 ticks. We're pulling this goddamn gnome this time. Fuck, where is this gnome going? The gnome's like following the goddamn boss. Actually running, I'm gonna look at my death log, see what hit me towards the end. Was running out actually what got me killed? 2 minutes 58 seconds into the fight. I took a static arc while having the debuff. Because that's like 6,000 damage there. So I must have had the debuff when that arc hit me. So if I didn't run out, the arc wouldn't have hit me. But I shouldn't have had a static arc debuff in the first place as the tank, like, basically ever. Yeah, I mean, running out to get the gnome was definitely a mistake. But I saw the gnome chasing someone and someone running it in towards me, so I thought they wanted me to get it off of them. And then it just got, like, moved out farther. All right, let's get some consumes. Show the warrior runes? Nope, because they're dead. Offline, is that correct? No, it's not. It's a UI error. They are online. Raid leader kind of raging. May I link log to fight? I mean, I think we should lay off the, like, dogpiling on this warrior. We understand the warrior isn't good. We don't need to, like, we understand. But we're gonna try to bring them along and, you know, get through this. So we're waiting for this guy to resurrect, and then the plan is to summon him directly to where we are. He got lifted up. I'm not sure where is he? Out in this zone. Not on the world map. But he's also not, is he like lost in Nomergon and he's not, he got back one time. We can't even res him because he died, he ran back. Then he, like, aggroed a patrol near the front. Go to the front to find Lapiness's corpse. Do a res on him. I'm guessing he died to patrol. Oh, okay. Excellent. Says about to enter. Got lost. Okay. At least we're communicating. He's alive. Summon quickly before he aggroes another patrol. We did it! We got the warrior back to us. And he already shouted twice. Absolute chat. You guys talking mad shit about this warrior in chat? We summoned him and he instantly battle shout plus commanding shouted. Let's Shadow Oil. Because I don't have anything else to put on my offhand weapon. Crippling Poison. I have Crippling Poison, but that won't apply to the boss, unfortunately. I would like to have a Deadly Poison. I just simply don't have it in my inventory. Planning for another long stream on Phase 3 release? I will stream more hours than normal, but I am not trying to do a 24-hour rush to Sunken Temple type of situation. Waiting for the boss to slowly walk back to this side. Everyone's, like, mostly... This guy is not in position. Wait, he's moving? Did he read chat? No, it's chat said stand on X, Gween. And he moved from here to here. But X is there. Okay. Oh, he arced before I wanted him to. Didn't get him all the way in position. There we go. Okay. Oh, I didn't put a new prediction up for the second attempt. Oh, well. Did I actually? Hang on, I can actually multitask that while tanking, because tanking this boss is incredibly easy. Okay, start prediction. Hang on. Pressing a couple buttons in game. Will we kill it? Yes, no. Okay, press a couple buttons in game again. Delete the third option. 30 seconds on the clock. You get 30 seconds to decide, are we gonna kill it? Prediction is up. I think we got, look, it's 50% and no one's dead yet. Evasion. I saw my health go slightly low. Okay, still no one's dead. Get Cold Blood Mutilate, because I don't have any other abilities I can use with Cold Blood. running the no in Venom build. Yeah, Warrior DPS is up to 24 this time. 26? He must have got a crit right there. Now it's back down to 25. Guys, we did it with no deaths. Machinist gloves are dropping. Never mind. Good job. I'm gonna stealth up to the next teleporter. Okay. Probably best to do it that way. And here we go. Will we kill it? Yes. Prediction pays out. Okay, we have sprint, we have vanish. I have no size increasing potions. We're gonna have to do a bit of a gamer jump here. Stocking up on true silver bars. I have a bunch of true silver ore. I'm gonna get mining on one of my characters. On the first character I level up, try to make a bunch of money at the start of the phase, and then go to like either enchanting or alchemy after that, I think. Or engineering, we'll see. We'll see what comes out with the new profession stuff. Made it past that guy, he didn't detect me. Okay. Okay, this part's kind of yikes. I can't do the jump as a female orc the way I do on a male orc. But I can do that. But you, like, aggro stuff when you do that. Right? So, like, if you get dazed or if you get one of the guardians casting a net on you in the, like, couple of seconds before you get up onto the ledge, it's not ideal. But I haven't had to do this on female orc character very many times. Haven't failed yet. That thing's gonna, yeah. This is also not actually an issue. Okay, might be a bit of an issue. We need to make it to the click thingy. Oh God, we're dead. We're dead, we got... I got fucked 2 feet from the goal. Sorry, guys. I didn't think that was gonna be an issue. I actually never failed this before. I could have fapped to avoid... See, we got dazed, that wasn't a problem. We got netted, that was the problem. The fap could have, FAP could have saved it. PvP trinket would not remove it. It's Charm, Fear, Polymorph. I don't have the rank 5 trinket that gets rid of everything. This is actually the first time I've failed that skip. Okay, if we have to do that skip again, we have to do it 3-minute cooldown on Vanish. Oh, this was a bad idea. There's a bunch of mobs down here that I didn't think were here. We're fine, we're stealthed. I might not be able to go again without Vanish. Let me think about this. I think I can go again. It'll just be slower because I'll have to wait up on the ledge. Nah, we should just wait the 90 seconds here. To wait the 90 seconds and do it clean, and we'll use a FAP at the end. At this point, I mean, it definitely would have been faster to just kill this stuff, assuming we didn't end up wiping. Not gonna risk this guy detecting me, because I'm waiting on this Vanish cooldown. Oh, shit. I think we can kill this. Whoopsies, wrong button. Nope. This is, slightly fucked. Okay, how do we beat this? We live for 8 more seconds, and then we fap and we run. Immune. Don't get dazed. Don't get dazed. We're in the clear. The FAP prevented us from getting netted. Now, because we're pretty low health, one melee attack might hurt us. So I want to distract those to the right. Sometimes as you walk past, they'll hit you like once. Arcano sentries. These things are immune to distract. Okay, we're in the clear this time. No alarm bot. What is this? Mechanized guardian. That's my corpse. How's my FAP cooldown? 30 seconds. We're good here. We're good here. On the mob. How? I mean, this is a situation of, like, I think everyone's attacking something different. Alright, let me put some consumes up. Okay. We're all here. We gotta res the hunter. Oh, the hunter might be AFK. Let's see. Okay, so I shoot this. I figured it out. I don't have alpha right now. Struggling to generate threat on a lot of those mobs. I was missing a 45% increased threat modifier. Mutilate seems now the only way. Should Blizzard nerf cost of it so other runes be more attractive? No. Here's the thing. People get mad when one thing is the best. And it's just like, one thing is always going to be the best. In phase 1, it was Saber Slash. In phase 2, it's Mutilate. And it's currently looking like it's going to be Mutilate again. You play Wrath at all? Well, once a week we log in and do a binding run. Yeah, this guy's been dead for quite a while. Someone said the warrior should tank. I said, I do not recommend assigning an important job to our warrior. Steal lockbox, let's go. All right, we're trying to get anyone in here that might only need loot off the last two bosses. Might be replacing the hunter, who hasn't resurrected for, I don't know, about 10 minutes at this point, and the warrior who left at Grubbis. I feel like Lapine's the warrior, who's still here, like, he's our mascot at this point. We're not replacing him. Roid Rage, you want to make a call as leader, or someone needs to steer this ship? I'm pretty sure you cannot inspect other players' weapon skills. No idea what weapon skills people have. You can ask him. We don't need to, like, brigade or make fun of the warrior. Like, we're all aware that the warrior is not very good or, like, aware of what's going on. We know. We don't need to, like, shun him for that. And, yeah, I mean, we looked at the logs. The weapon skill probably isn't maxed. Knowing exactly what it is, not concerned. Okay. I'm gonna be right back real quick. Take a quick bathroom break. They are trying to... Oh! Wait, did they... Please don't tell me they kicked the warrior. I was just saying how he's our mascot, and we got him through this whole thing so far. Why don't we take him across the finish line? I'm seven manning this thing anyways. I don't know if that's a kick. I don't know if it's, that guy left on his own. Because it doesn't say anything differently. You know, from here. Right. Be right back. Time for a quick bathroom break. We'll see what happens when I get back. Down 2-7 players from 7 players?
Yep, that's true.
Go, electrocutioner, damage done. What? No, he did one explosive shot on a electrocutioner, it looks like. Serpent sting, 34 ticks, auto shot. This is attack from the pet. Interesting. Wait, these percents don't add up to 100. I hate details so much. We've got to go back to recount. I'm gonna be honest, we have to go back to recount. What the fuck is this? Percent of total doesn't even add up to 100. I'm amazed how so many people can use details and think it's good. Like, how do you fuck up a damage meter add-on? But the animations of the bars and colors on the bars are prettier. What point will you give up on the pug? When the pug gives up. I'm no quitter, okay? I'm not going to be the one that, causes the disband. But Roid Rager is saying that's it. Port's here. Thanks for coming. 4 out of 6, guys. Electrocutioner is, frankly, more than I expected. GG's. We have 2 people left. Oh, Femboy Kisser says he just got one, but we just have 2 people have gone. Mage has made a portal and then left the raid group. Classic mage move. GG's, okay. Yeah, Lapine's left our mascot, and then the group immediately fell apart. Coincidence? I don't